So the respiration is again here two types of respiration. So one is aerobic respiration, another one is anaerobic respiration. The respiration is going on in the presence of oxygen. The respiration is called aerobic respiration. Anaerobic condition, it is a partial oxidation of food material. So what is the basic source for the food for respiration means, that is glucose. From where the glucose can obtain to the respiration means, the glucose basically come from the photosynthesis. But in animals, the respiratory substrates are different. Even the plants also, they are different. What are the respiratory substances? So carbohydrates, proteins, and lipids. Carbohydrates, proteins, and lipids. Carbohydrates means here, the simpler form of carbohydrate are glucose and fructose. So all the type of respiratory substances do not involve directly into the respiration. They go for the partial cleavage. The intermediate products formed during the cleavage, they are involved into the respiration. It means there is a need of conversion. So the complex materials are turned into the simple forms, then they involve into the respiration. You are seeing the proteins. What are the proteins? Proteins are polymer of amino acids. It means the proteins, in the presence of protease enzymes, they are turned into the simple forms. They are amino acids. Okay. So when the amino acids are cleaved or break down into the simpler form, so like alpha-ketoglutaric acid. So this can involve into the respiration. It means it is a simpler form. It is complex form. And like lipids. Lipids are, so in the lipase enzyme, in the presence of lipase enzyme, the lipids are converted into the glycerols and fatty acids. You are seeing the glycerol here. So the glycerol do not directly involved into the respiration, but it wanted to change, it wanted to transmit as phosphoglyceraldehyde, PGAL. So this PGAL is involved into the respiration. So here the complex compound is turned into the simple compound. So due to the beta oxidation. Okay. And what are the fatty acids? The fatty acid also involved in the oxidation. Due to the oxidation reaction, the fatty acids are converted into acetyl-CoA. So this acetyl-CoA is also one of the intermediate compound present in the Krebs cycle. It means the Krebs cycle is initiated by acetyl-CoA. So this acetyl-CoA involved in respiration. Okay, like many respiratory substances are converted into simpler form, then they are involved in the respiration. Okay, so cellular respiration, respiratory substances. And how the process is going on means, the process is two types. What are the processes here? The respiration is two types, aerobic respiration and aerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration means what we seen. It means in the availability of oxygen, the respiration carried out. So such type of respiration is called aerobic respiration. And anaerobic respiration means here, after formation of the intermediate compound, when the absence of, in the absence of oxygen, it turned into the ethyl alcohol. For example, in anaerobic respiration, you see here, it turned into the prokaryotic cells where the oxygen is unavailable. Okay, so the glucose can turn into acetaldehyde. So here, in the presence of some microorganisms, in the presence of enzyme, that is zymase enzyme, here the glucose has been converted into acetaldehyde by losing of one carbon dioxide molecule. Then here the acetaldehyde is turned into ethyl alcohol. Here the little amount of energy is released, that is 56 kilocalories of energy is released. Okay, but whereas in aerobic condition, there is a oxidation of glucose molecule that resulted to production of high amount of energy. So how it is taken means C6H12O6. So what is this? This is the glucose, and by taking of oxygen, 6 O2 molecules, here it can converted into 6 CO2 and 6 H2O, and how much of energy? So 686 kilocalories of energy is released from the one glucose molecule involved in the aerobic respiration. So here the complete oxidation is carried out that resulted to releasing of carbon dioxide, water molecule, and high amount of energy. So these are the aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration.